One of the best features of the Lacrosse View app has to be its ability to easily share device data with family and friends. In this video, we will show you how to share devices, manage users, accept device invites, and explain how the sharing permissions work. So, let's get started. In order for this process to work correctly, all of those who wish to receive shared device data must have their own Lacrosse View account with separate email and login credentials. This will make more sense a little later on. But as you add devices into your Lacrosse View app, you will be established as the owner of those devices, meaning you will have the ability to invite others to receive your data as well. To share device data, go to the main menu, select the Devices tab, and then press the Share icon in the upper corner. Doing so will bring you to the Share Devices page, which will display a list of all the devices you own, and therefore can share with others. Again, only the owner of a device will have the ability to share its data. Now, to do so, simply select the device or devices you'd like to share and press the Invite User button at the bottom of the page. This will bring up a dialog box prompting you to input the email of the user you'd like to share your devices with. You can manually input the email or press the plus button to access the contacts stored on your mobile device. But either way, please make sure to correctly enter the email they use for their Lacrosse View account, and then press Invite. After which, you should notice that a number 1 has appeared in that device's row. This indicates the number of users that have been invited to share that device's data. If you tap the device name here, you'll move to its Manage Users page, which will show a list of all the emails you've sent invites to, along with status messages next to them indicating if that user has accepted the invite or not. This is a great place to check and make sure you've entered the correct email address for the users you'd like to share device data with. Remember, for them to receive this shared device notification, they will have to have their own Lacrosse View account created using this email address. You can also use this page to delete shared user permissions. Simply press the red minus button to the left of the email you wish to delete, and then press the delete button to the right. If you're on an Android device, you'll simply have to press on the email and swipe left. Please note that deleted invites will automatically remove the user's sharing permissions, and they will no longer be able to see this device's data in their app. Once you have all of your invites sent off, you can press Done in the upper corner to bring you back to your main screen. So now that we've shown you how to send device invites to other users, let's cover how to accept those invitations and add those shared devices to your app. First off, if you're a new user without a physical weather station of your own, and plan to start using the app by simply accepting device invites from another user, you can actually skip the setup steps that follow the creation of your new account by selecting Later when the Account Created dialog box appears, as you won't have to worry about the connection process or scanning in any device IDs. Shared device invitations will be sent directly to your app's notification center. The icon's cloud will turn red and show a number for the amount of notifications you have. Simply tap this icon to enter your notification center, which will be divided into two tabs, one for alerts and the other for devices. As these are shared device invites, we will select the Devices tab here to view our invitations. These will include an image of the device, the owner's name, and the device name assigned by the owner. To add this device to your app, simply tap the Add button. Here you can give the device a name and assign it to a location. Once you have these adjusted to your liking, select Done to save the changes and start seeing that device's data in your app. Sharing devices in this way will give each user complete control to rename, set alerts, and adjust its placement within their device order, all independent of the other user's settings. That's the beauty of having your own individual accounts versus sharing one between multiple users. Keep in mind also that just because you're the owner of some devices, doesn't mean you cannot accept device invites from other users. There really is no limit to the amount of device sharing or accepting you can do in the Lacrosse View app. We hope this video helped you to better understand how to share and accept devices within the Lacrosse View app. But if you should have further questions or issues with any of the topics covered in this video, please just let us know in the YouTube comments section below. We are here to help you. In the meantime, don't forget to hit the subscribe button at the end of this video to receive all of our latest content and further video instruction. Thanks again for choosing Lacrosse Technology.